girl Clo, aka Miss Chloe Chantel. We are back with another airing of The Chat Room. Yes, 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 yes. I am here with a special guest, one of my favorite comedians and the most sexiest, beautiful, gorgeous woman of comedy. Miss Heather Hatton, how are you doing today?
Thank you. I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. It's Monday. Monday's winding down.
Yeah.
And of course, my girl, Miss Maya D, my left hand to my right, is here in the studio with us. Gonna add a little commentary. So, Miss Heather, tell us how you got started with comedy and things of that nature.
I actually got started because a good friend of mine, he's actually an entertainment attorney. His name is John Childs.
Okay.
And, you know, we've been friends for a long time. And so I used to just, that he's actually like my best friend. So I'll just call and just be talking to him. I'd just be talking crazy. And he was like, "You are so funny." And I'm like, "What are you talking about? Like, I could be in the middle of saying someone the bad kids did or something." And he was like, "It's just your delivery that makes it funny." And so I was like, "Okay, fine, whatever." And then so he said, "Well, they have open mic at Times Square," which is where like Steve Harvey and Rashawn McDonald and all of them started. And it's here in Houston.
Okay.
And he was like, "Well, you ought to go to Times Square and do open mic." And I was like, "Okay, fine, whatever." So I actually went and I did it. And it's been a green light ever since.
Ever since then?
Yeah, I mean, the crowd received me well. Because when I perform, I don't tell a joke. I don't tell not one joke.
Right.
It's just me talking, and I guess, like you said, it's my delivery. Huh. That's all it is. So.
And is this something that you knew you were funny when you were little? It sounds like something that you just kind of tapped in when you were older, and it's just kind of like, I'm kind of funny.
No. You know how you had a family in the hood?
Uh-huh.
Right? They in the hood, but they do things outside of the hood.
Uh-huh.
Like, I went to private school. I was a gymnast and stuff like that.
Gotcha.
So, I never really thought about comedy because I was in private school with the nuns with them little plaid skirts on.
That's comedy in itself sometimes.
Yeah, so comedy was not on my mind, but I was a gymnast. Mm-hmm. I actually trained with Bella Caroli, the one that does the Olympics.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so I wasn't no little BS little gymnast.
Right.
I was actually a gymnast, so comedy was the last thing on my mind. Then of course I had my baby when I was 16.
Mm-hmm.
So now that's when I went from private school to public school. Mm-hmm. That's what that public school gets you right
there. Don't it though?
That's a public school gets you right there. Had a whole baby.
It's funny, they always say private school is worse than public school.
No,
you're a little bit more mischievous in private school. Mm-hmm. So it's the other way around.
It's the other way around. Hmm. Well, because I was in private school, I was so restricted. So I didn't know what freedom was.
Until
I got to public school. And yes, I went to all girls school too.
Oh.
Maybe I got to be around the boys.
Oh.
I had my baby. Yes, honey. I get out them uniforms.
Ain't surrounded by them girls no more. See a little testosterone in a way. Hormones don't know how to act around that age.
Then I say I got pregnant 16. Yes, I got around the boys. I said, "Ooh, I got some boys in the class."
So I know one of your biggest taglines, you're the sexiest woman of comedy.
Yeah.
Sexiest B-I-T-C-H in comedy.
Yeah, yeah.
So what made you go with that tagline?
Actually, my old manager, I've been through quite a few managers, but my old manager actually gave me that tag because people would come up to me, they would think I was a rapper for whatever reason.
Hmm.
Because they said I don't look like your normal comedian. And I was like, okay.
What does your normal comedian look like?
Now, when they said that, I did kind of research it. And most comedians are not received as sexy or glamorous.
Right.
They're received as, nothing against a Whoopi Goldberg or nothing, but they're more received like a Whoopi Goldberg or a Rosie O'Donnell.
Gotcha.
You see what I'm saying?
And see, when I thought of that, I guess when I think of women comedians, I think of kind of larger, too. I think of Monique and all that stuff like that. Okay.
Right. I would think maybe like the only one right now is maybe like some more.
Mm.
But other than that, they're not considered. Most female comedians are not considered pretty or attractive.
Right. They're just
or
funny.
Sexy. Yeah, they're just funny. Mm-hmm. And a lot of them use their funny to offset them being fat or to offset kids teasing them. And I'm just like, you know what? God made me like this. So if I could use this to get a little change, then whatever.
Right. You can use your good looks for a reason.
Yes,
go ahead and use it. So tell me what a set is like. If I go see you performing here in Houston or wherever, what's the typical kind of set for you? Do you play off your sexy needs? Do you play off jokes, stories? I know you say you don't do jokes, but what's a set like for Heather?
I would say a general set for me is I am probably one of the only few comedians I do not mess with my crowd. I don't do that.
Okay.
Because I feel like if they took the time to come and see you and go get them some nice little clothes and to put on a nice little lace front, I'm not going to embarrass them by coming
in. Exactly.
So
that's nice.
I don't do that.
You know, and I